So welcome here students. Today I am going to start the exercise 7.1. Here I have written the question number 1. Students, in the previous videos we have discussed about the different criteria regarding the congruency. So I had explained the three criteria like SAS, ASA and AAS. So you need to revise that three criteria to give the solution of the question given in exercise 7.1. So here it is the question number 1. In quadrilateral ABCD, AC equal to AD. It is given that AC equal to AD. Here you can get the diagram is also given in the book. ABCD, here it is a quadrilateral in which AC and AD are equal. Here AC and AD, AC equal to AD, that is given. AB bisect angle A, AB bisect angle A. It means here AB is going to divide the angle A into two equal parts. Now you need to prove that triangle ABC and triangle ABD are congruent. Triangle ABC, here it is a triangle, and triangle ABD, here it is the triangle. You need to prove that both are congruent. And then it is asked what can you say about BC and BD, so that is the part which will be find after proving these two are congruent. So if you are going to prove the congruence, it is the geometry based question, so some specific sequence are there to solve this question, or you can say that some proper steps are there. So here I am going to explain. Always you will start the geometry question with the given. Here I am going to write the solution. First you will write given. In the given you will write the whatever the terms that are given in the question. Like here in the question it is given that in quadrilateral ABCD AC equal to AD. That is given in the question. So here you will write AC equal to AD, it is given. It is also given that AB bisect angle A. It is given that AB bisects angle A. Now you need to show that. So that yeah, you can say that to prove. You are going to prove, yeah, you are going to show that triangle ABC congruent. That is the symbol of the congruency. To triangle ABD. So in this question you need to prove that triangle ABC congruent to triangle ABD. So these two things you will get from the question. These two given and to prove you will get from the question. Now your solution will start from here. Proof. So again it is called the proper steps. In the geometry question you will give the solution of all the question in the same format. First you will write given, then to prove, and after that prove. Now students, if you are going to prove two triangles congruent, so we have discussed the three criteria SAS, ASA and AAS. If any of the criteria you are going to apply in these two triangles, then both will be congruent. So here AC and AD, that is given equal. It is also given AB bisects angle A. It is given in the question. It is given. Then it shows that if AB bisect angle A, what is the means of this? It shows that these two angles are equal. It means angle CAB equal to angle DAB. It shows that angle CAB equal to angle DAB. It is the symbol that is going to indicate it shows that. If AB bisect angle A, it means that angle CAB equal to angle DAB. Now you need to write these two triangles. You are going to prove in triangle ABC and triangle ABD. You need to prove that these two triangles are congruent. ABC and ABD. Students, if you are having any doubt, you can draw the rough diagram of both the triangles. Here it is ABC, that is the triangle ABC, and here it is the triangle ABD. I have drawn both the triangles. ABC, ABC, and ABD, ABD. You need to prove that both are congruent. So here in both the triangle it is given that AC and AD are equal. That is given in the question. AC and AD are equal. It means in both the triangle one side is equal. So here you will write in these two triangles AC equal to AD. It is given. From here you are going to write this statement. It is given in the question AC equal to AD. Now next. Angle CAB. Angle CAB, angle CAB equal to angle DAB, equal to angle DAB. In both the triangle, one angle is also equal. So here you can write angle CAB equal to angle DAB. From where we are going to write this statement, it is given that AB bisect angle A, that's why angle CAB equal to angle DAB. So you can write it is also given. Now, you got the one side and one angle is equal. If you are going to two triangles congruence, you need to search the three values which are going to follow the congruency criteria. So for the third, here AB is the side in the first triangle as well as AB is also the side in the second triangle. So AB equal to AB, that is common side. Here in the main diagram you can find in both the triangle AB is the side which is common. AB is included in the first triangle as well as in the second triangle also. So here you can write AB equal to AB, that is common side. Common side. Here AB is the common side for both the triangles, so AB will be equal to AB for both the triangles. So here, if two sides, here you can find if two sides included angle, two sides included angle. If two sides are equal, the corresponding two sides are the other triangle and the angle included between these two sides, whatever the sides are equal. If these are equal, then both the triangles are congruent. So here it shows that triangle ABC congruence to triangle ABD. And what the congruency criteria you are going to apply? That is the SAS criteria. SAS means two side and one angle you are going to show equal. So that is the way to solve question related to congruency. That is the proper way which will be followed in solving the question. So if you are going to prove the two triangle congruence, so write the two triangle name and show the three values equal, that is going to follow the congruency criteria. Here I have shown three values are equal. So according to side angle side, which is the criteria, first criteria I had given, according to that both the triangles will be congruent. Now here it is written after proving congruence, it is given that what can you say about BC and BD? BC and BD. What can you say about BC and BD? So students, if these two triangles are congruent, so here it is BC, here it is BD. BC and BD are here. So what can you say about the BC and BD? Here BC and BD at the corresponding sides. BC last two and BD is also last two. So if two triangles are congruent, then corresponding angles as well as corresponding sides will be equal. So here you can write BC equal to BD. Here it is asked, what can you say about BC and BD? So BC and BD, two triangles are congruent, then their corresponding sides as well as corresponding angles will be equal. So BC equal to BD. And here you will write CPCT. What is the means of CPCT? CPCT means corresponding parts of congruent triangle. So you are not supposed to write the complete line corresponding parts of congruent triangle. You will write in the short CPCT. It means that corresponding parts of congruent triangle. So here it is BC equal to BD. So it is the complete solution of the question number 1. You need to write it. Here I have written the question number 2nd of exercise 7.1. In the question it is given that ABCD is a quadrilateral in which AD equal to BC. So first I am going to see the diagram. Here it is given ABCD. You can find in the diagram also which is given in the question. It is a quadrilateral in which AD equal to BC. It is given that AD and BC are equal. Here it is going to indicate in the diagram also AD and BC are equal. And angle DAB equal to angle CBA. Angle DAB equal to angle CBA. So these two angles are equal. Then you need to prove that triangle ABD and triangle BAC are congruent. You need to prove that triangle ABD and triangle BAC that are congruent. So here if you are getting any kind of confusion in the diagram, so you need to draw the two triangles separately. Here triangle ABD, triangle ABD, here you are going to get the triangle ABD. So I am going to draw that triangle separately here. It is like this. So here it is the triangle ABD, ABD and BAC, BAC. Here it is the triangle BAC, so I am going to draw it. It is something like that. It is BAC. So So students, you can draw the rough diagram which will indicate both the triangle on in which you are going to do the work. So triangle ABD, from the given diagram here you are going to get many triangles, so you may get the confusion regarding the triangle. So it's better to draw the two triangles which is asked in the question. So I have drawn both the triangles. Now in the solution, what is the first statement that will be given? In the previous question also I had explained that geometry based question having some proper steps. So in the given, it is given that AD equal to BC. So AD equal to BC, and one more thing is given, and angle BAB equal to angle CBA. These things are given. So AD equal to BC is given, and angle DAB equal to angle CBA. Angle DAB equal to angle CBA. Now in the question, what you need to prove? You need to prove three parts. So you will write all the three parts: triangle ABD congruence to triangle BAC. Second part you need to prove BD equal to AC, and third part you need to prove angle ABD equal to angle BAC. So these three parts you need to prove. Now next statement, proof. Your solution will start from the proof. So whatever the given and to prove is there, that you got from the question, and here you will start the proof. So in the proof, you will take two triangles. In triangle ABD and triangle BAC, I am going to work in these two triangles. Reason is that in the first part we need to prove that both the triangles are congruent. So in both the triangle, in the question it is given that AD and BC both are equal, AD equal to BC. So here you can find one side of both the triangle is equal, that you got it easily. So here you will write AD equal to BC. It is given in the question. Now it is also given that angle DAB, angle DAB, this angle equal to angle CBA, equal to angle CBA. Here one angle is also equal in both the triangles. So here you can write angle DAB equal to angle CBA. It is given. So here to prove any two triangle congruence, you need the three values, and here already two values are given in the question. Now here you can find AB and AB. AB in the diagram also you can get AB is the side in the first triangle, as well as AB is the side in the second triangle. So AB is the side which is common in both the triangles. AB is in the first triangle as well as AB is the second triangle. So here you can write AB equal to AB. It is the common side. It is common side. So here you got three values: two sides included angle, two sides included angle. So if two sides included angles are equal, then both the triangles are congruent. So here two sides included angle, two sides included angle are equal, then both the triangles will be congruent. So here it shows that triangle ABD congruence to triangle BAC. What is the criteria used here? SAS criteria, side angle side. By this criteria both the triangles are congruent. So that is the first part. First part is proved. Now second part, you need to prove BD equal to AC. Now sir, look here, BD AC. If two triangles are congruent, so their corresponding parts will be equal. So BD and AC are the corresponding parts. Here BD and AC are corresponding parts. So here you will write BD equal to AC. If both are congruent, so by CP, CP, CT means if two triangles are congruent, then their corresponding sides as well as corresponding angles will be equal. So BD equal to AC, that will be by CP, CT, corresponding parts are congruent triangle. Now angle ABD, now look here, angle ABD equal to angle BAC. Again these are the corresponding parts. If both are congruent, so angle ABD equal to angle BAC. So here for the third part again, you will write angle BAD equal to angle BAC. अगेन इट इज बाय सीपीसीटी. सीपीसीटी मींस करेस्पॉन्डिंग पार्ट्स आर कॉन्ग्रुएंट ट्रायंगल. सो बोथ आर कॉन्ग्रुएंट, सो एंगल एबीडी इक्वल टू एंगल बीएसी. एग्जैक्टली यू आर गोइंग टू गेट द करेस्पॉन्डेंस. सो इट इज द कंप्लीट सॉल्यूशन ऑफ द क्वेश्चन नंबर 2. काइंडली नोट डाउन द सॉल्यूशन.